Star Wars in 1977, when the movie happened, I grabbed my wife and my two-year-old son, and we all went to the drive-in, okay? Everything looked so much better than any other sci-fi movie. I went to a theater to see it again the next day. I'm a game designer. My job is to make a pinball machine to make the best one I can possibly make. I design the play field, how the ball moves, what it does, the devices. It's my concept.
My role in this game is everything that's not physical. So all video, all sounds, all rules, all scoring, all lamp effects, that's me. Star Wars is very important to me. I'm more connected to Star Wars than any other project I've worked on, and I'm trying to pour the kitchen sink into this game.
There's aspects of the three movies that we're working from, episodes 4, 5, 6.
When I try to design a game, I try to design it with giving the player as many choices as I can. When you push start, you choose your character. There are 16 missions. All while you're playing these missions, scenes from the three movies are playing, over 400 scenes. It's working your way through the movies the way you want to. The game is epic.
You want to be a hero, you want to make the correct shot, destroy evil. You have to have a TIE fighter you can shoot at. Isn't that every person's dream to be to get in an X-Wing fighter and go have a major battle with TIE fighters? I mean, if you're an adventurous soul, that's what you want to do. And you have to have an exploding Death Star.
So destroying the Death Star is pretty fun because it's kind of a difficult challenge. And along that path, you know, you hear the John Williams music and, you know, the sound effects, you know, of spaceships flying by. And then eventually, if you succeed, you blow up the Death Star and you go into Victory Multiball. When I'm done playing it, my heart's racing. I'm happy and I think that I could have done more and I want to play it again.
I deal with the entire geometry of this game. So I developed the Death Star and the hyperspace accelerator.
So the accelerator is a major toy in the game. There's a shot that feeds balls into this loop. And a ball is going around and around and around and around in the accelerator, and then another ball comes out. So you're flipping one ball, but your main goal is to put the second ball into the accelerator. And if you succeed, then you got two balls going around and around and around, and it kicks out a third ball. It's badass.
It's almost kind of scary. It's like, you know, it shakes the whole game. It's cool.
When this first came online and going around, we're like, yes, and everyone came in and looked at it. We're like, oh my God, this is gonna be so cool. Like, people are just gonna go nuts. The way it works is there are four magnet coils. There's a certain delay that is in software, and so by the time it reaches from the first magnet to the last, it is going much faster.
So we're gonna go out to the line here and check out Star Wars. I think this is my 30th something game, I don't know, but still very exciting. These are all Star Wars going down the line here. These ladies are the solder ladies. Hi, ladies. Fun to work at Stern. The game has a nice little display here, which I love, because the game is really fast. The ball speeds are incredible. You get a lot of information that you need to. If you look up, you know, oh, what am I supposed to shoot at? It'll tell you. Let's start. I like to get a player. I'm going to play Han, and I'm going to like a Tatooine mission. I love playing on the line because you can cheat so terribly. It's awesome. I get into how the ball moves. I make smooth playing games. I like every shot to be smooth and fluid. Once you make a shot, it comes back to the flipper and you can make another shot. We call them combos.
I think the game is a fight. It's a battle. It's a hell of a lot of fun.
Star Wars attacks your senses in virtually everything that it does.